again with another episode of
podcasting
from beyond the grave.
Dun, 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 dun. And we got some a little bit of everything again today. We got some Batman,
and we have some anime.
And we got some anime.
Why does everybody like Batman?
So not really everything, but we have Gotham and we have anime.
Yeah. Well, I say a little bit of everything because we got Dragon Ball Z, we got Fairy Tail, we got
Demon Slayer,
and we got Batman.
So, lots of different anime and
Batman.
Mm-hmm.
And Batman.
I recognize three of these people.
Which three do you recognize, Jay?
Batman, Dead Nightwing, and Vegeta.
Ah, Vegeta. Which Vegeta is that, though?
I don't know. Purple Vegeta?
No. That's not purple.
Trunks hair purple? Trunks Vegeta?
That's Super Saiyan God Vegeta. Jason?
Oh, okay.
Get up on your anime. Him and Urza.
He really needs to get into Pulse.
Yeah, he needs some Pulse of anime in him.
Well, yes. Hanging out with you young folk here is really helping me learn.
And that's kind of funny because he's the one that got me into anime, folks. Yeah. I don't understand him.
Yeah, then he's falling off the train. The Mugen train.
He's following the Mugen train. He's just rolling down the side of the hill now.
So we can segue from that into opening up.
Start off with some, what? Some anime?
Let's start with some anime.
Alright, we got some.
I rewatched this movie lately.
And this is and Dragon really Slayer?
Demon Slayer.
Demon Slayer.
Mugen Train. This Mugen demon.
Train?
The movie.
Okay.
Explain this character to us.
This is one of the upper ranked demons. And he is the secondary antagonist in the Mugen Train film. So where he wasn't that cool demon who was the sleep demon on the train. But he's the one who comes in after that one's killed and takes out the Flame Hashira.
I thought he had a very cool character design over it.
Oh yeah.
I love this one.
And I've never bought anything like this before, so this is actually new to me.
Is it like an adult action scene?
It's an import doll. I just thought he was really cool in the movie.
Oh, he comes together.
So when I saw him like that,
yeah,
that's nice.
He's got a nice base to him. Got some tassels and some tattoos. He's smiling, so he seems like he's a good guy, right?
Oh no, he's not a good guy at all. In fact, he's pretty menacing and evil.
Wow, that's pretty good. Pretty good paint on that.
I was going to say, these Bandai and statues like this, the detail they put into these guys.
Well, there's full-on good detail on the back and everything.
This guy made Tanjiro cry.
Well, with a face like that, yeah.
Why did he make him cry?
He killed his friend.
Oh, that's probably why.
And then he messed him up pretty good, too, from what I remember.
Look at my eyes. Them were cool looking.
Yeah.
Good detail in them.
Yeah. And this came from the State Fair, like the most odd place to find anime, but there was a woman with a bunch of stuff from Japan in her booth, and I saw this guy, and I thought, I'm going to get something cool at the State Fair.
The hair is really neat.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is something different to put on my shelf with my Fairy Tail Funkos and my Death Note statues.
Yeah, it's me bringing in all these Dragon Ball and anime stuff.
Yeah.
I'm slowly working it in on y'all.
So I'm glad I bought him.
Look at these ankles. The little what would you call them?
Crunch berries.
There you go.
That's a different conversation. We won't bring up cereal this time.
Bust out the Frank Berry, he'll be over in a second.
Okay,
what's
so who's
next?
Alright, well, we'll switch it up. We'll go from anime to Batman.
More Todd figures.
We hadn't had a Todd figure at all this
so
round of episodes.
This wasn't a special order or anything, was it?
No, this was on the shelf at Target.
Okay, I have not seen any of these on the shelf yet.
Well, they have the Superman and Black Adam.
Okay.
But this is the variant Batman who is an exclusive to Target. And he is the 7-inch page puncher. Last time we looked at the small page punchers.
Yes, yes.
I believe with the spaghetti monster.
Yes.
And so this is the larger page puncher.
So it comes with a comic. Is that an existing comic run that's going on right now, or is it an older book, or what?
I want to say it is a original book that's exclusive only
to the figure.
There you go, Donnie. You can throw that box away.
Okay.
If you open the comic.
Oh, it has the cards.
I didn't think he was in there.
Is he staying?
Now these are a little more expensive than the average Todd figure. I think he's 25.
Okay. So he's on.
Card that matches the comic book. Comic book with it.
So this is a one-off book?
Yeah, I believe so.
Like a one-shot gun?
Well, I'm having a lot of trouble getting him out of this thing.
So I think if it's Batman, by looking at the cover of the book, must go with the or fight Black Adam or something, I guess.
With Black Adam starring in that film coming up, I can't see him being a villain anytime soon. As we're going to keep Black Adam as a
anti-hero,
as an anti-hero at very most, because with all the drama at DC here lately. Now here we go. We finally got Batman out. Get him on his, and you know you got to love it, Todd. Gives all the figures the base.
Yes. I will say, I've seen the painted figure, the regular figure.
Of this
and
one?
I don't like it that much. The choices of coloring, I don't really like it. But I will say, this looks really good, this particular version.
I have so many Batman figures that the only reason I bought this guy was because he was... this weird black and white.
Yeah, it's like a
chunk
sketch,
yeah, like
or something
chunk.
Like that.
Yeah.
And what do we think about the comic?
It's not great. I recognize the cover artist as somebody who's been around. The inside, it's colored very well. The artwork is mediocre to me, but it's. Definitely tries to bring out a bunch of characters throughout the book, so hopefully besides just old people buying this, a kid can buy this and get a comic with an action figure, and that sets them on their wonderful journey through buying comics and collecting and reading.
Who'd have thought that Black Adam would have been one of the major DC characters.
I do like that cape. It's pretty damn awesome. We've got stitch lines, and it looks like the cover artist. It's based off of his designs. There is lots of nice detail you can see within the fabric and the clothing. Like I said, that colored version of it, I don't really like. But this one, all the detail really works for this particular figure, I think. So if I saw it, I might be interested in getting it.
So it's kind of really like nice. If the light was hitting them on the one side.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I like.
Because he is the knight.
He is.
But he would be in real trouble.
That's a pretty good figure.
If he encountered this guy.
That's a nice outlier to put with your collection.
I think so. Kind of like that Zurinar Batman and some of the other.
Yep. Yeah, I dig that a hell of a lot more than the actual version of that. That's really cool.
It's a cool cape, too.
Yep. And we get a batarang, at least.
And get some shit kickers on him, too.
What's next?
I don't know. Y'all call it.
Let's get another anime character open.
Let's go for another statue. Let's open up Mr. Vegeta there, Jason.
Vegeta.
Pass.
So, this is...
This is Super Saiyan Guy Vegeta. He don't come into this form until the Broly movie.
I mean, how do you decide when you're a god and call yourself a god version of yourself?
Well, I can explain that a little bit. Goku and Vegeta go to the God of Destruction's planet, Beerus, which is a big purple cat, if you know anything about Dragon Ball.
Okay, yeah.
So Beerus and his angel Whis train them so they can be more stronger than they already are. And so, as the gravity and stuff on Beerus' planet is more, so their strength goes up faster, and he teaches them how to become god-level beings in their pyres. So, this is them all jacked up on that god juice.
Jacked up on Mountain Dew.
Yeah. Well, that's why Goku trains on King Kai's world, right? Because the gravity is so strong there. It makes him work that much harder.
All right, now look at that stand. That's kind of interesting.
Oh, that's good. So it'd be transparent. Put a little light in there. Well, I will say that is some metallic hair.
Man, that's some shiny hair
super,
for sure.
Super, super godlike purple hair. Mm-hmm. That is really the nonchalant, you know,
yeah,
that's somebody out.
That's definitely a typical Vegeta there. Just yes. Like, I don't give a shit, you're gone.
Yeah.
I like that even though Vegeta became a family man, he still stayed cranky and...
Yeah, he still stayed himself.
I love the family trip to the amusement park.
On Super? Yeah.
Where he takes Bulma and Trunks to the...
to the amusement park rides.
The amusement park rides, and he ends up at the, magic show or something at the end. It was the dance park.
He gets to the dance. That's when he takes
it. I really identified with that a lot. I felt Vegeta in that scene. I was like, I understand, because sometimes I get like that.
Because you'd rather be training on a gravity-rich planet. Because
I'd rather be doing anything sometimes.
And what you're supposed to be doing. But yeah, for someone that started off as such a real big badass and when he first has appeared in the animes and the manga, he's definitely come... Built his character very nicely, I think. He's definitely got... Well, there's a lot of people have more of a fandom for Vegeta than they do actually Goku.
Yeah. Well, his character has had a greater arc where Goku is... His purity has never been in question or anything, and he's just always been...
Goku's not as interesting because he's kind of like a Silver Age Superman. He does no wrong, and he's...
Right.
He's always right.
He comes in at the last minute and saves the day.
Alright, so if you've been watching the channel, one of those people that have been, you would have seen...
Other than us.
...that we've covered lots of these DC...
Deceased?
DC Direct figures. Because DC Direct was actually discontinued.
And then McFarlane Company picked it up.
Well, they agreed to release these figures that were already made.
So I guess these are the other ones in this series.
Yep.
So we had a new
line
of the deceased figures. And Nightwing being one of my favorite DC characters, even when he's all ugly with a head.
Yeah, ooh.
I had to get this guy. And I really...
You think there's a crowbar?
What, a flaming crowbar did that?
Well, Dick's one of the Robins that never really had a problem with crowbars, but...
Man, that is a stout, stout figure. Ooh, that's not so good. Got that place paint right there on his joint. Other than that, he's got lots of blood.
Yeah, he's far bloodier than some of the other ones before.
Yeah. I was going to say, yeah, more on his costume and stuff of the other ones.
Now, I have the regular one.
I didn't see the crunch there.
But I hadn't opened him, so I thought with this one, I'll get the zombie version of Grayson and open him up.
Yeah, got that.
So you don't come with no better ram or nothing?
Sticks or anything. No sticks.
And these guys are not... They're not cheap. They're about $30 figures. So except for the Red Hood, if I find Red Hood, I might get him, but I think...
Yeah, he looks pretty cool with the torn open mask.
And he's one of the unkillables.
The Red Hood is?
Yeah. So there's two DC's figures, and then there's Unkillables, which is Slade, Deathstroke, and Jason Todd.
It's like Batgirl.
Yeah, Batgirl's a deceased figure. So Batgirl and Nightwing are deceased, and the other two are the Unkillables.
Yeah, that Red Hood looks really...
The deceased was a fun line. I've been going on about the DC versus vampires, which I've really been enjoying. Well, I want those figures out. They need to. Somebody needs to do those.
It's kind of the best of both worlds for you, though, since you're a horror fan and a DC fan.
Oh, yeah, I love when they match up horror and comics, and I think that's why I like certain animes like Demon Slayer and Death Note so much, is because there's real horror elements in those.
Yeah, he's very cool looking.
So this is a real grim assortment so far. We need some lights. We need somebody
to lighten our darkest hour.
To lighten up this mess of...
How about another redhead? So who's this, Brad?
This is... Well, she has many names. What are... She goes by Urza Scarlet. She goes by Titania. She was one of the most powerful wizards in the Fairy Tale Guild.
I think she was even the master for a second, and then she kind of talked her way out of it.
Well, you know, when we first meet her, and I don't know if the manga is written this way, if he knew he was going to introduce people like Gildarts, but originally it seemed that only Loxus and Mistigan were considered more powerful than Urza. Everybody was scared of her. Natsu and Gray and everyone. And it did seem like Loxus and Mistigan were the only two that were... And then to me, it always felt like Gildarts came along and just upped everybody out of nowhere. But I don't know whether he had that planned out or... I read somewhere that he did just kind of go along with the flow sometimes.
I did see a video where they was talking about the first designs of her. She was supposed to be a Amazon punk rocker. Have like that, you know, like a Wonder Woman kind of Amazonian with a punk rock do. So I was like, you know, her desk, I go, oh, I would like to see them drawings to see what they look like. That was interesting.
Did you ever find them?
No, I just, like I said, just seen the video where they was talking about it, but never seen no actual.
And she has a lot of iconic looks, but to me, I kind of like her in this armor.
Yeah, this is her original armor. And it's like you say, she has different armors for different attacks. And
well, she re-quips.
Yes.
So when Urza re-quips, that is that she's going to change or upgrade her armor while during battle. She can change and upgrade her swords while she's in battle.
Yeah, she can come out with as many swords as she wants. She's kind of like a...
And you know what would be great to go with her? I don't know if they make male figures in this line, because I know you have Lucy, but
sword.
If you had Jalal,
I haven't seen a Jalak.
To go with her.
Where does her sword go?
Now, they got a Natsu and a Gray.
From this line, I think I would need Natsu at some point.
She come with extra hands or something?
I think it goes behind her. Like she's...
Let's see what's going on.
Yeah, what's the boxing like?
Yeah, it kind of fits in behind.
Oh, okay. You got to take part of the hilt out,
and then slide it through her hand. Okay. Yeah. Ooh.
See those anime model kits at like Target. Mm. I always wondered what those looked like.
That's gonna be bad. That's, my hands are too big. Need tiny fingers to put the bottom of the hilt on.
But yeah, it's definitely a very important character in the fairy tale.
Yeah, this is gonna have to be done off camera. Because that is... You don't want to lose that. Oh, yeah, she's one of the four, of the big four.
Yes.
You know, I put her and Gray at equal levels of importance.
Yes, I would say so.
You know, Natsu and Lucy do share the co-protagonist.
Right. Well, it's more Lucy's story anyway, I think. I feel like the whole series is kind of like she's the main character and we're just following her around. Because you start off with her in the show. Lucy.
We do start off with her. So that's, but it's just hard not to watch the show and not believe it's Natsu and Happy's story for the most part.
For a lot of it, right, yeah.
They do kind of take over. But no, I see what you're saying, though. Lucy is kind of our eyes through everything.
Right, because she is the writer.
Everman. Or the every person.
She's a struggling author. Yeah, these are really cool. And this is what Sahali got at the anime con, right?
No, she got the Cow Lucy.
Lucy. Yeah, tell us about the company that made this.
This is Pop Up Parade. They make a lot of these characters. And they're the few we have are just every single one of them is just like this. It's dead on to the source material. And it's a Japanese company. I had to order this one. Actually, we got it at a good price online, and then now that they've sold out of them, they've went up in price, I think like $80 for that now. And we got it when it first came out, so we got it at least for 40 here, but yeah, them things are very sought after and expensive, especially when they're coming out of, when they run out of.
Well, I think all three of these anime figures really complement each other.
Oh, yeah. I would like to get a decent Vegeta statue. I just want regular, I guess. Maybe yellow hair.
Super Saiyan?
Yeah, just Super Saiyan. I've got one Vegeta figure I plan on painting, but I'd really like to get like a really decent statue of him. And if I saw that Batman out somewhere, I would probably get him. Because that costume and that design and the way that particular one looks, I really like it. And every anime figure I see always looks cool. It's like half of the time I was like, I don't know who that is, but that's so cool looking.
Yeah, there's so much creativity in anime that
the armor just looks great.
Yeah.
There you go, that's cool. That's cool. Yeah, that's a cool little picture there, guys. I like that.
It's a gruesome fivesome with four gruesomes and one
Albino Batman.
One princess.
Dead Nightwing. Tattooing Captain Crunch. And Revlon hair Vegeta.
Super and Saiyan God Vegeta.
The girl that don't take no shit from nobody.
No, she does not. Did you get her sword he'll put on her?
No, I ain't got it on yet. But
yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's not going
to
be
easy.
That's
going to have to be a...
That's worse than Zartan's monkey paw.
And like hold your breath for a second or two and go...
I'm going to get some tweezers, I think.
Well, Mahaley may have to do that for you.
Oh, what are you talking about? She's scared of putting these things together. That's why we're doing this today.
All right. Well, thank you all for watching.
Yep.
Go buy everything.
And
like and subscribe.